Colleagues, I talked in the morning about the issue of meetings and how we can maximize on it. Is it the most efficient way of making management decisions? So like I said, as UNICEF, we spend a lot of time in meetings. On average, on any given day, a UNICEF officer will spend 2 to 3 hours in a meeting, or even more, or 2 to 3 meetings. Some of those meetings are within the office, some are external, and I'm going to define internal and external in a minute. Some requires that they are at their desk or in a conference room, but some also means that they have to go out, physically go out. So when you factor in travel time, especially if you have to go to meet with a government counterpart or a CSO partner, and it takes in a lot of time. So the internal meetings are those that are with UNICEF staff, among UNICEF staff, among the staff that are within the either within the same office or with other staff members in satellite locations. Some of those, most of those satellite locations are, the meetings are online meetings.
Okay.
You will have a teleconference, video conferencing, Skyping, all those kind of things. Ultimately, they take time. They still take time. And how efficient they are is the question that we would like to ask. So despite the volume of those meetings, a number of the sheer number of meetings, the question remains, are they really necessary? And the other question is, are they most efficient and effective options for management decisions? And three, are there alternatives to meetings that could give us the same results without having these large volumes? Can we have any other alternative? So my objective really is to recommend management decisions on meetings effectiveness, value for time and money. Looking at, do we have, is it value for time? Is it value for resources? And the second thing is establish an island, a change island, on how meetings are conducted and managed based on co-shared values, ensuring effective contribution of all participants. So, and then those are my two objectives. And my strategic approach is to using the knowledge, value, culture, maturity analysis framework. Review the nature, purpose, efficiency, and effectiveness of meetings as a management decision tool. And by doing so, I'll be looking at the engaged section staff and other members on the conduct of meetings to develop shared values in how meetings are being conducted towards the creation of an enabling environment for staff to feel empowered to find innovative ways, innovative and sustainable ways of empowering colleagues and staff on decision-making processes.
That's very good.
So those are the kind of things that I would like to see. Now, I have suggested from how do I actualize that, I have looked at 4 core activities that I need to do to make this happen. And one of them is to conduct a desk review. Just do a desk review on, because right now I know in my mind that meetings really do take a lot of time. But I can't tell you data, numbers. I cannot. So I'm going to collect data on the numbers, the type of meetings, the duration, the outcome of those meetings, and the general perception about meetings in the office. That is the first thing that I'm going to do. The second thing is I will engage with my own staff. Engage with my own staff to develop a standard questionnaire for obtaining feedback. to obtain feedback on the efficiency and effectiveness of meetings as a management tool, and to develop with them core shared values in terms of how do we conduct meetings when we must have them. That means getting everyone to participate, you know, in terms of they feel that the meeting is not being called by my boss, but that I have something to contribute to this meeting. It's worth my time. It is part of my job. I need to go, not to tick the box that I attended a meeting. But if we have a set of shared values and perceptions about meeting, that a meeting text is a good, it is in my interest and the interest of the program in charge of to go to the meeting. So, and when I do, this is the 1, 2, 3 that is expected of me. So those are the kind of shared values that individually I feel that I have something to contribute in a meeting, and not that this has been called by my boss. We are supposed to have a head of sections meeting every Wednesday, and therefore everybody needs to come, even when you don't feel like you have anything to contribute to it. So that is the developing of those shared values. And how do we intend to do that? It's by consultation.
Now, before you go into that,
yes,
if I can pose a question.
Thank you.
On maturity analysis,
yes,
you remember the concept of phronesis?
Yes.
I think why people are doing what they're doing now,
yes,
it's because they have not matured,
yes,
in terms of their knowledge, values, and behaviors. Mm-hmm. And so there is what you want them to know.
Yes.
There is a knowledge which, yes, you want them to know.
Yes.
Knowing that the moment they know it,
yes,
you will be at that level where it's superb. There is a question of values.
I'm not going to let that pass. That is important.
There is values which you want them to know, mm-hmm, like time,
yes,
efficiency,
yes,
wastage of money.
Yes.
This is part of the values. Remember the 5,
yes,
issues we said: respect for life,
yes,
information,
yes,
property, that's value,
yes,
environment, and social justice,
yes,
the beliefs.
Yes.
There is something which you would want them to know.
Yes.
If they know it, then they will be at that level of value maturity, the highest level of maturity in their values. There are some behaviors.
Yes.
The actions.
Yeah.
You know, when we say walk slowly or walk faster, or take risk, don't take risk, take precaution, or do this. These are some of the behaviors which probably you would want to be demonstrated by these people, but they are not. So what are these behaviors? What are these values? What are these knowledges which, before you go consult with your peers, what is it that you have you want to bring on the table to these people?
One is, one of the values is respect.
Start with the knowledge, maybe?
Yes.
What is that we want them to know?
What I want them to know is it's both process and but also technical. Process, mm-hmm, in terms of meetings are there for a purpose.
Mm-hmm.
They serve a purpose. And if the purpose is not clear to everybody, there's no point of having it.
Mm-hmm.
So people should have very clear objective of why we attend meetings.
So what is it that you want them to know? It could be they don't know.
Mm.
They are unskilled.
Mm. Mm.
Yes, they have technical knowledge, but yes, they have not matured. You remember what we,
yes,
said?
Yeah,
they have.
Right.
They are not grown to that level where you see things and you value the meetings.
Yes.
What exactly do you think they need to know?
You remember you talked there. We were talking about yesterday about how do we gather and disseminate information.
Mm.
So, and it's not just the gathering and dissemination, but it's also the type of information, the quality of information,
yes,
that we need to be to have in a meeting that could help in the decision-making process. A meeting is not the kind of place where you would go and, for lack of a better example, start talking about the weather.
Yeah.
If your meeting is on logistics or more customer support and how the rapid response to customer support. So, what value is the quality of the information that you want to give in a meeting that will facilitate the decision-making process? And can we have that value? Can we have that quality packaged in a simple, easy to understand manner without going into, when I was in Brazil, we faced this thing and I did it, and even when I was in Egypt, I did, oh yes, you did that, but we are here in Zanzibar.
Yeah.
Our client is in Stone Town.
Yeah.
We would like to minimize on the number, the details, and just focus on on how do I respond to this client.
You are right, and I'm getting you, and I agree with what you're saying, but you have not answered my question.
So,
you know, in this kind of we from the learning purposes, there is what we call epistemology.
Yes,
the knowledge. And number two, the ontology speaks about how do we know it. You want to get someone to know about what is a mango, what is it?
Okay.
But how do I get someone to know that this is a mango? How? Now, the next bit which you're going to go is how do you get them to know? But I'm still sticking on the first issue of a mango. How, what is it? That, what is a mango?
Transfer the word mango to what is a meeting.
Yeah.
Yes.
So you now, you need to come up with what is it that you want them to know.
Uh-huh.
I think that's what they don't know. If they know it.
I'm not sure I also know, but for me, my purpose. So I'm sorry, but I'm not sure I get what you mean 100%. Because for me, what I know is that we are not using time optimally.
Good.
We're not using time optimally.
Yes, but do they have a knowledge of time? Do they have a knowledge of efficiency? Do they have a knowledge of money? If someone understands what time means,
yes,
they wouldn't waste time and start talking about Brazil and all these and these. Now you're coming to the point. Maybe they don't know what are the meetings or what meetings are. And so when you come to the meeting, what should you bring into the meeting? Or why should you attend a meeting? So that's why I'm trying to emphasize that when you polish up the paper, you need to come up with what exactly you want them to know.
Understood. I hear you. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Maybe my colleagues have something to add to this. Useful.
But now, about the values.
Yes.
What values do you want them to have as you propose for a culture island?
Respect for self and others. That is one.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to have a culture in which people, this is our shared value, that we have a common goal. At the end of the day, it is our decisions that we make from this meeting as a direct bearing on the overall performance of the organization.
Okay.
And that because everyone has a bit to contribute, so the respect for self and others, for me, is one of those values.
Okay.
And two, that we need to keep our eyes on the ball, or on the ultimate outcomes, rather than the process that we go through.
Good.
So if we have a meeting that we decide that this requires a meeting, then our purpose should be clear. What we intend to achieve out of this should be very clear for all of us. and that we can actually evaluate, did we achieve it through this meeting, or could we have achieved the same results in a much more efficient way if we used an alternative route?
Okay.
That is the kind of value that I would like to see through.
And also you made an emphasis that there's a question of diversity, where
yes.
you have Asians, you
yes.
have Africans,
yes.
you have these, that people should be sensitive
yes.
to what others
yes.
stand for.
Yes.
Now, when it goes to behavior, what are the issues that you would want them to know?
One of the issues is one of the behaviors that irritate me is people coming to meetings late.
Good.
When we say it's coming at
uh-huh.
10, they start at 10.
Uh-huh.
That is a behavior that I would like. Oh, it's not a big problem, but you still have situations
yeah.
where somebody comes into a meeting 10 minutes after it started.
Yeah, because it chokes the inefficiency. It
yes.
comes to the inefficiency.
Yes.
Yeah.
And two, the other behavior is if we're in a meeting like this, unless you tell us to put on our laptop, I have been, like today sometimes, on my phone. How do you conduct a meeting? I'm on my phone because I'm distracted, because I'm thinking about my bookings. So I go into my phone, but in the meantime, I lose out on what you say.
Yeah.
So for me to catch up, I have to think backwards and get myself back into that mode, because I already left it mentally.
Okay.
So those are the kind of practice to make the best use. I'm talking about the conduct of a meeting and the behaviors that make meetings inefficient, coming late, and knowing that this meeting is set for 1 hour, and if it starts at 10, it will end at 11. If it rains, if the sun comes up, whatever, it will end there.
Questions?
Yeah, my question was regarding on the use of Mr. Indian already mentioned that the use of knowledge
yes.
to the people in order to make them efficient on attending meetings and the meeting participation. But what are their attitude towards those meetings? And what is their, can say, cultural practice on those meetings? Are those two affecting in one way or another during meetings participation in attendance?
Yes. Like Edward just said, it sometimes people are so diversified. You have people from all races, from all religions, and if you're going to have a meeting that is scheduled at 11 or at 12 to 1, and our Muslim colleagues want to leave the meeting for 15 minutes to go and pray, so you will see that you've lost, because of lack of planning, you've lost half of them because you scheduled a meeting at a time that coincides with something. People are going to pray.
Yeah.
That is where religion and practice interferes majorly into the conduct of the quality of the meeting. Sometimes also, especially meetings that go outside of the office, you wonder whether, is it necessary or, I'm not saying it is, but you can't help wonder, is this an excuse to get out of the office?
Okay.
Yeah. So those are the kind, some of the negative cultures. But then again, on the plus side, there are people who just love to be engaged, to be involved. If you came to my office, you talked to me, you're much more likely to get more out from me than if you called me. If you called me, as it's just that is, doctor is calling again. What for? And I will say okay, and I forgot. But if you, we had a meeting, I came to your office and I say, doc, I want to see you. This is what is happening, and you say okay. That decision is much more serious because you are not booked. You sometimes so, their meetings have very useful purposes. But and I'm not saying that we don't need meetings, We do need meetings,
okay.
But we just need to maximize on them and just decide whether this particular meeting is necessary, and if it is, how do we make sure that it gives us the outcome that it was intended for? Does that answer your question, Ali?
Yes.
Thank you.
I have a question based on knowledge a bit,
yeah,
with your team. Like you said, there's a diversity. You have like different kinds of people.
It's basically any race that you can think of in this world is there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So considering that, putting that in mind, the first question that came into my mind when you were presenting was, does each one of them understand the importance of that meeting first?
Mm.
What are they going to get out of that meeting before they even step in?
Mm.
Like, what is the use of this meeting? Number one. Number two, are they prepared mentally for that meeting? Because for us, in our meetings, we send agendas before the meeting. So each one knows who's going to say what, and they prepare the questions and their mind. Do you have like reminders or set agendas that everybody presents their agenda before you go? Number three, during the meeting itself, if the agendas are present from before, is the engagement different from when they don't have the agendas beforehand? Or do you plan the agendas while in the meeting? So these are my questions.
Thanks. Yes, people know why there's a meeting.
Okay.
Meetings are called for different purposes.
Okay.
You will have our the senior management meeting, there is also meeting with a partner, you want to discuss the project implementation or discuss a proposal. But there is also the section meeting where, you know, the C4D, for example, the team meets together just to see where are we with our programs. So every time there's a meeting, there is people, as we assume, they know that the purpose of the meeting. Meeting are not just called ad hoc. Some meetings are long established, like for example the weekly coordination meeting, what you call the heads of section meetings. That is a long established tradition. People need to come and meet. But so when new people come, sometimes they are not even sure that what happens in this meeting. Do we need to take note? Do we need to have the culture for that meeting, because it's been there forever? So people don't really get to understand, but they bring in their own attitudes and views about where the meeting is. But they do know, it's explained to them, this is our weekly coordination or planning meeting. Do we have an agenda? Yes, there is a standing agenda that is being discussed. What are your priorities for this week? What are the key challenges? What is happening in our operating environment? What has happened? Do we have a bomb somewhere? Are there airstrikes in this particular place? Where are we having outbreaks, disease outbreaks? Do you have measles? Do you have polio? Do we have teachers being paid salaries? What is happening in our operating environment? So that is the moment where you get that.
And is everybody free to set an agenda? For example, there are 15 people coming to a meeting, and someone sent a reminder saying, we have our meeting today at 8.
Yes.
My agenda is this.
Yes.
Is it free for anybody to set their agenda that I would like to present this agenda? Or do you have to go through a procedure until that agenda is approved?
No.
It's open.
It is open.
Okay.
Yeah, it's very, very open.
Okay.
All those regulations about that is standard fare.
Okay.
My problem is not whether people know why they are coming.
Mm-hmm.
It is what he was talking about, some practice there.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? Do you feel railroaded into a meeting, or do you feel that this serves an important purpose for you? Because it is all competition. You have to prioritize.
Mm-hmm.
You have 20 reports to write, all right? And then you know that Zanlink is asking you. You know, every Wednesday at 10 to 12, you have to go. So you decide, do I need to spend 2 hours to listen to 15 people say the same things, and then I come back to my 20 reports? Or can I just go there for 10 minutes, and then I come back to my report? You understand what I'm trying to say?
No. I'm coming to you. Yesterday, you said that your value system is sitting on holistic.
Yes.
whereby you can adjust to the realities of one's existence,
yes,
and accept the existential dichotomies, mm-hmm, as they are and go on living.
Yes.
And actually, when we talk about cross-cultural decision making,
yes,
to respond now to your first questions where I said you jumped the gun,
yes,
cross-cultural focuses on hybrid,
yes,
frameworks, which are also drawing on a holistic view. So with the decision making system, we try to develop frameworks which are holistic frameworks. So we align to your views as well. We think from your same views as well. Now, how is that compromised, or how is that disturbed? Your views, how are they disturbed with the kind of people you have, where their practice are very far from where you are? You see, if you do a dotted line, where do you see the other people? How far are they from your line? You know, when you do the plotting.
I wouldn't say that maybe they are very far. Maybe they are just not expressing it in the manner that I am.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's good, because I think within the UN culture, these issues of tolerance and respect for diversity,
mm-hmm,
is one of those key values that is implanted in you,
mm-hmm,
that you need to respect diversity. Whether that diversity is on the basis of race or even sexual orientation, that's okay.
Yeah.
But of course, your own background and your own, as much as I will say your behavior sometimes might not be very pleasant to me, but I respect it.
Yeah.
For my behavior, it's not very pleasant too. It's not something, the way I talk, the way I dress, the way I respond to people. Maybe in your culture, in your background, you might not give me full marks for that.
But now, what is the kind of a culture island do you have in your mind? If, say, you are successful.
If I was successful.
Yeah, to do the cultural transformation.
If I was successful, yes,
yeah,
that's a good question.
Mm.
If what I would like to see is a situation where, one, our meetings don't take as long as they need to take.
Like 1.5 hours, how long?
Maybe 1 hour max.
Mm-hmm.
Two, I would like to have a situation where we are clear about, you know, did we achieve the outcome of this meeting, the desired outcome?
Mm-hmm.
And if we did, was that the best way of doing it? Do we have alternatives to meetings? We don't even have to have meetings,
mm-hmm,
or at least not as many as they are.
Mm-hmm.
So that is the kind of culture islands,
yeah,
that I would like to see. That probably instead of a typical staff spending 2 to 3 hours every day in meetings, that we could probably just spend an hour.
Good.
Yeah.
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 Good.
Yes.
I'm not sure if it was yesterday or today. You said that normally your meeting takes 1.5 hour.
Today morning.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, and you have proposed the island, you want to have maximum 1 hour. So, what does 30 minutes impact in your daily operation?
Okay. Spoken like a true engineer. Engaged in that meeting, Probably we will not need to take 3 hours. Probably we will need to take only about an hour or two. That is one. And two is about measuring our value for time. Did we achieve what we set out to achieve within these 3 hours? Because you take 12 or 15 senior officers to spend 3 hours, that is 3 by 12 man hours. Right? So 3 by 12 man hours, that's already, if there are 12 senior officers, that is 36 hours. Right?
Times dollar.
So if we look at the man hours wasted in 3 hours, just you asked me, so I'm trying to respond to you like, you know, if we decided that at least it would take 2 hours instead of 3 hours, you shall have reduced the man hours by half. So you can start calculating what kind of dollars you're saving by that kind of thing. Right? Yes. So, did that answer your question?
Yes.
Thank you.
Can I ask another question?
Sure.
Okay, so now that you have already realized the problem and you already have in mind what you might want to implement.
Yeah.
Do you think that in case you manage to put your idea through or your plan through, don't you think that limiting it to 1 hour might limit people from engaging more? For example, if you manage to sort this out and people understand the meaning of effective meetings and you put your point across, I have noticed that in our organization many times when we limit time, we limit participation.
Mm-hmm.
That people are not very open to
mm-hmm.
sharing the views, they think
mm-hmm.
they were running out of time.
Mm-hmm.
But whenever we leave a meeting open, we get more from our people. They
mm-hmm.
they participate more, considering the fact that we're not in a rush. It's
mm-hmm.
just a psychological thing that goes in mind. Now, how would you tackle something like that if you have set a 1 hour, approx 1 hour thing, and people, it's intense, they participate. Would you allow more time, considering the fact that now it is more effective and there's quality for the meeting, or would you still stick by your 1 hour principle?
I thought I responded to this 1 hour thing. It's not prescriptive.
Mm.
The 1 hour is not a prescription. But
meeting should take 1 hour. I responded to Ali about this.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not prescribing 1 hour as the be-all, end-all kind of solution to effective meetings.
Okay.
You can have a meeting for 4 hours. You
okay.
can have a meeting for the whole day.
Yeah.
My question is there value for time? You understand? Is there value for time? Do you have returns out of the time that you spent in those 3 hours? Or could you have done this in an hour? Or are there situations where you don't even have to have that meeting and try an alternative way of decision making? Because we love to say that we have consulted, we have participated, we are involved. These are words that we use. Participation, involvement, consultation. But consultation does not mean I sat there for 20 hours or 30 hours and I'm like, okay, I participated. Is it value for time? That we talk about value for money. But I'm asking you, I want us to have this question also, value for time. Yes.
You see, that's why in our framework,
yes,
we come with the issue of measurements.
Yes.
Knowing that most of the frameworks, they don't look into these dimensions.
Yes.
When
yes.
people come into a meeting,
yes,
is it meaningful?
Yes. Yes.
To me.
Yes.
To you as an individual. What
yes.
does it add up to you as
yes.
an individual? To
yes.
the organization or to the institution? How much does it impact on an organization? But again, we look it into the community, to the
mm-hmm.
clients.
Mm-hmm.
Where does it go? To me, if I was going to set up an evaluation tool
mm-hmm.
and indicators, I would map them using these dimensions.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you have in your mind in terms of the kind of indicators? That's why you see these questions are coming again.
Mm-hmm.
Because you try to mention about 1 hour. You know, an hour is a unit of measurements.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you see most of the questions are coming.
Because it's easy to quantify. Because people, they can relate to an hour, in their heads.
See?
Yes.
Now,
but
so,
you can't relate to the quality of engagement.
Sure.
It can.
Yeah.
If you go do your finalize,
yeah,
and polish up whatever proposal you have, try to put as more indicators as much as possible so that people can see where does it impact. Instead
uh-huh.
of time, it could be some other quality. When you say quality of engagement,
mm-hmm.
what are the key issues exactly
mm-hmm.
which you want people to look at? When you say quality of an engagement, what does it mean?
Yes.
When you say this and this, what does it mean? So it's a question of measurements and the indicators. And I understand in this, you also need to have details on the current monitoring and control procedures. Basically, you have to come up with what the current situation. When you're saying the quality of an engagement is not good, what is it?
Or could be improved.
Could be improved.
Yes.
To which extent?
Yes.
Or to
true.
What extent?
True.
And what are the measurements?
Yes. So in terms of that, I'm not
speaking, or I will get brownie points for the number of times I speak in meetings.
Yeah.
But whenever I might say a little, but it makes sense, it's listened to.
Yeah.
Those are the kind of things that I'm looking for.
That's very good. Thank you. Thank you
very much.
Uh-huh.